Today I'll be comparing two popular DJ pools, BPM Supreme and Direct Music Service, or as we'll refer to it in this video, DMS. The largest thing I'd like to discuss in this video is the pros and cons of both subscriptions. Now, I do have a comprehensive review out right now of DMS. I will make sure to put a card right here. Now, I'm pretty cheap, so one of the biggest things for me to talk about is price. On one side, you have DMS ranging from $30 to $60 a month, and on the other side, you have BPM Supreme ranging from $20 to $30 a month. And you get different inclusions in each. For DMS, we're just going to discuss basic to highest level subscription as you add little things on in between. Mostly for DMS, their subscription pricing model is based around the downloads that you can download each month. The bottom tier only allows you 40 downloads of tracks, samples, everything. And the reason that I specify samples is because a sample might only be a 3 second or 15 second long clip, but that counts as one download. At the highest tier with DMS, you get unlimited downloads of all their content, which is great. However, it's $60 a month for that package. So beware that you're gonna be paying a lot of money if you want that unlimited downloads. Now, if you're more into the unlimited downloads, you might like BPM Supreme better because BPM Supreme includes unlimited downloads in both of their subscription tiers. Now they only have two, it's $20 a month and $30 a month. The lowest tier includes the basics that you need to use the subscription. Unlimited downloads, basically access to their music, their mobile app, things like that. Really, that's what's important about it. BPM Supreme's highest paying tier, which is $30 a month, adds features like playlists, high quality streaming, and Cloud Rescue to their service. However, a key thing that I want to point out here is that, first of all, DMS includes high-quality streaming no matter what subscription level you're at. So, if you're looking for high-quality streaming, you might want to use DMS over BPM Supreme. The thing is, though, that they work out to be the same price for BPM Supreme's top subscription and DMS's lowest subscription. The last thing that I have to mention about price is that the reason BPM has this higher price tier seems to be more of a streaming service. You might have heard that I mentioned that playlists and high quality streaming. Now, the last thing we have to talk about on price is intro offers. BPM Supreme has a $10 a month introductory offer. Of course, that is only for your first month. It does allow you to get started on the cheap. DMS kind of has a welcome offer. If you use my link in the description below, you'll get a $10 off coupon for 1 month. So your first month will go from $30 to $20. If you sign up but don't quite pay for the subscription on their website, they'll send you an email for a $17.97 or something subscription level. However, this is completely an introductory subscription. I believe with this level you only get 20 downloads, whereas if you use my link and pay the $2 more approximately, you get the 40 downloads of the regular bottom tier subscription. So that is an important consideration. I would say go with the same price and double the downloads. Right now, I'd like to lightly touch on the mobile apps of both subscriptions. I did mention both of them already, and in the DMS review, I do have a section about their mobile app, so check that video out if you want to see specifics of the mobile app. But basically, they're both pretty similar. BPM Supreme just has a little bit more functionality for a streaming platform type of app compared with DMS. That's really about finding the music for yourself as a DJ. I do have a slightly chunky review out of BPM Supreme's mobile app. If you want to check that out, I'll put a card in the video here. As I said, it's chunky, and what I mean by that is it was shot on my old camera. It was kind of out of focus. Sorry. Okay, so now let's get to the most important part of this comparison for DJs, the music library. If you're a DJ, which I imagine you are since you're watching this video, the most important thing for you on these subscriptions is probably going to be the music that they have. But not only that, also the types of edits, whether it's intros, clean and dirty edits, remixes, all stuff like that we're going to talk about right now. DMS absolutely reigns king in the library completeness category, absolutely by a landslide. BPM Supreme kind of lacks in the area of older music or back catalog. Also, oddly enough, BPM Supreme is missing certain tracks that are on the newer side, like Highest in the Room by Travis Scott, No Guidance, and it's pretty typical with Travis Scott songs in general. I'm not sure why. Another pro of DMS is that they have clean and dirty edits for like 99.9% of songs on the site. With BPM Supreme, one thing I've noticed is that a lot of hip-hop rap songs that are natively dirty do not have a clean edit. And mainly this is an issue if they're not quite mainstream. And what I mean by that is like they're not necessarily a radio hit. Although there are radio hits or TikTok hits that are very popular and that people are going to be requesting at events that do not have a clean version. DMS, like I said, is very, very good with the clean. They have clean edits of basically every song on the site. However, we do have to give BPM Supreme credit in this video that they do have the widest range of edits, meaning intros, radio edits, explicit and clean edits, as well as remixes and bootlegs and such. The main thing that BPM Supreme wins by a landslide over DMS is the fact that they have radio edits on all of the tracks, or most of the tracks. DMS does not seem to have radio edits on any tracks, and that tells me that DMS is more of a club DJ subscription and that BPM Supreme can kind of go both ways. It can be club DJs and mobile DJs. As you may know already, I do both, so I find that DMS isn't necessarily the right fit for me. As far as search capabilities, BPM Supreme wins in this category primarily because their search is quick and for some reason it works better than DMS's. And what I mean by that is when you search for something on DMS, you're going to get an enormous catalog because DMS has an enormous catalog. Now, there's a benefit and a downside to this. It's very hard to organize DMS's search window to see if you're looking for an older song or a newer song. You just get this enormous list, and it can be really hard to find, and you can go through pages and pages and never find what you're looking for. BPM Supreme, on the other hand, is very snappy. The problem is, going back to what I said earlier, their library is lacking a little bit, especially in the back catalog area. The searches usually come back very easily because there's not a whole lot that they have from the older back catalog type of music. As for remixes and bootlegs, BPM Supreme wins by a landslide here, kind of. The thing about BPM Supreme is that they have a lot because they do accept tracks from individual creators, so remixes and bootlegs that aren't necessarily sponsored by the artist or the record label. But the problem with this is sometimes the remixes are not of a good quality or they fall into the wrong category. DMS has a good enough amount of edits and redrums and stuff. There is a larger focus on redrums on DMS than remixes, although they do have a fair amount. And I can say that the ones that they do have are pretty good quality. You're not going to run into some of the problems of homemade junky remixes like you will on BPM Supreme. DMS kind of filters for quality a little bit more. If you're a club DJ, solely a club DJ, you might want to consider going with DMS as you'll get more of the intro edits and more remixes and such. If you're a mobile DJ, you probably want to go with BPM Supreme unless you really, really focus on having intros of tracks. But I think a lot of mobile DJs don't focus on that specifically and they want the radio edits. So for that case, I would definitely recommend BPM Supreme. Now there is one special case here that if you're looking for back catalog, you might want to go with DMS over BPM Supreme. However, I do have to caution you, there are better subscriptions for that as I'll discuss in a later video. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please leave me a thumbs up down below. And also, let me know which subscription you've used or currently use in the comments below. I do want to answer all of your questions as well, so if you have any questions about either of the subscriptions in this video, please leave me a comment below as well. Please hit that subscribe button, and that's gonna be it for this one. I'll see you in the next one, but until next time, peace. Today I'll be...